I told you yesterday, what do you mean by memory?
Ability of a computer to store something.
Ability to store data. Ability to store data or information. So computer is also having the memory because it is a it is helps us to process our information, process our data and produce the information. For that purpose, it also needs the ability to store that data and information. So memory is the storage brain of computer which holds the data during the processing. And storage devices or storage unit is responsible for storing any kind of information which we need permanently, which we need to store permanently, which we can retrieve as and when required. Later on, whenever we required, that's so that we can retrieve that information. So two types of memory, mainly two types of memory are in computer. One, primary memory to store the information during the processing, and secondary memory to hold the data for a longer period. So various storage devices, we all of you know, CD, DVD, USB, hard disk, floppy disk, portable hard disk, memory, pen drives or USB drives, memory cards, floppy disk, which is an obsolete device, which is not used nowadays. We are not having even drive even. Then CDs, DVDs, and Blu-ray discs are also there, which can be used to store the data. Now, next part is CPU. That is your central processing unit. A processing unit which will process the data which we enter into the computer, and it works like a brain of computer. Like our brain, our brain controls our parts, body parts, our reactions to the situations, our actions. So everything that we that our brain controls, our body parts. Similarly, CPU controls the parts of the computer. That may be input devices, that may be output devices, and that may be your storage devices. So all the parts of the computer are connected to CPU by using system, by using some wires, and it controls and directs the internal operations of a computer. It directs and controls the working of all the parts of computer. It may be input devices, it may be output devices. So it is also known as microprocessor or microprocessor or processor, that is a CPU, central processing unit. There is only one processing device which we use in computer. Many input devices, many output devices, and many storage devices. But processing device is only one, that is CPU. So there are three parts of computer. Can anybody give me the names of three parts? Yes, Nitya, what are the three parts of computer CPU? Yes, Nitya, what are the three parts of CPU? I want to see how many of you are sitting attentively in the class, whether you are not switching on the camera, but yes, Vanshika. That means Nitya is sleeping. He is not giving answer. Yes, Vanshika, what are the three parts of computer?
Ma'am, ALU, arithmetic logical unit, control unit, and memory unit.
Very good. Arithmetic and logic unit, control unit, and memory unit. What is the function of arithmetic and logic unit? Yes, Kavarnur. What is the function of arithmetic and logic unit? Kavarnur, I think you are also sleeping. Give me the answer. Nitya and Kavarnur. What is the function of arithmetic and logic unit? Either switch on the camera,
yes, ma'am,
or give answer.
Yes ma'am.
Bolo beta, what is the use of arithmetic and logic unit?
Ma'am, it controls the functioning of computer, like mainly calculations.
Mainly calculations. It do perform all, it is responsible for performing all the calculations or computations. It performs all the arithmetic and logical operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, logical operations like finding out the greater than, less than, or equal to, or not equal to. All the logical and calculations, arithmetic calculation performance operations are done by the ALU. So what is the use of registers or memory unit? Memory unit is also known as registers. What is the function of registers? Yes, Pranay, what is the function of registers?
Stores the data.
Stores the data. When? Stores the data. During processing. Yes, it is kind of RAM. Okay, registers, it is a short but very fast memory which is used to store data temporarily during the execution of the program. Whether we are getting the input from the input devices and that input is stored in registers. Arithmetic and logical unit will take the instruction from memory unit, from registers and do the processing. After the processing, whatever the result, it goes back to registers and registers send it back to the output devices. So registers are the intermediators in which we store the data and information before sending it to the output devices and before sending it to the ALU for performing the calculation. So there we are continuously giving instructions, we are continuously typing, and register is queuing that things and sending it to ALU. ALU is performing the performance actions and operations and sending it back to the different part of the registers, and they send it back to the control unit or the output unit. Okay. So what is the use of control unit? Anyone? What is the use of control unit? Okay, Simran. Yes, Simran. What is the use of control unit?
Is used to take out all the functions and directs the flow of data.
It directs the flow of data from the input devices to the registers to the ALU, or from the ALU to the registers or to the output devices. It controls the flow of information or data in between all the components. सारे कॉम्पोनेंट्स में जितनी भी इनपुट जा रही है, आउटपुट आ रही है, कैलकुलेशन हो रही है, रजिस्टर्स में जाना है, सेकेंडरी यूनिट में जाना है, तो वट एवर द डाटा होगी, वट एवर द एक्शन वी आर डूइंग एंड वट एवर द आउटपुट वी आर गेटिंग, ऑल द प्रोसेस, ऑल द फ्लो ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन एंड डाटा इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय द कंट्रोल यूनिट. कंट्रोल यूनिट विल चेक यस इनपुट डिवाइस से कोई इन्फॉर्मेशन आई है, कोई डाटा, कोई अल्फाबेट एंटर हुआ है, इट विल सेंड इट टू द वेदर इट इज सेंड टू द रजिस्टर्स और इट इज सेंड टू द एएलयू डायरेक्टली. तो इट विल डिसाइड, कंट्रोल यूनिट विल डिसाइड, इफ द एएलयू इज फ्री इट विल सेंड इट टू द एएलयू, इफ देयर इज अ क्यू तो इट विल सेंड इट टू द रजिस्टर्स, देन फ्रॉम रजिस्टर्स टू द एएलयू. After the ALU, it comes back to the registers. So control unit will decide ki where the which information or where the data should go, or how to make the flow of data. It is used to direct the entire computer systems to carry out or execute the instructions. It manages the data flow between the various components of the computer system. It will decide whether the instruction means and directs the necessary, what the instruction mean, instruction ka kya meaning hai, and directs the necessary data to be moved from the memory to the arithmetic unit or from the arithmetic unit to the again memory. It performs the arithmetic unit will perform the calculations or actual operations, and the result of operations is again stored back in the memory or registers directed by control unit, controlled by control unit. Okay, so all the three components work together to do the processing. Control unit will control the flow of data, register will temporarily store the data, and arithmetic and logical unit will perform the calculations or operations. Now, there are important terms, that is your instruction time. Now, all the components of the computer are connected by using the special wires called system bus. They are called system bus. Okay. And the instruction time means the time in which an instruction is fetched from the memory and stored in the instruction register is called the instruction time. That means the control unit gets the instruction from the memory and directs the necessary instruction to the arithmetic and logical unit. That is called instruction. Understand the instruction and send it to the ALU. That is your instruction time. Execution time is the time that the program or ALU takes to execute a particular task. That is called execution time. Instruction time in which the time in which the instruction is fetched from the memory, memory se fetch karna, read karna, understand karna, and sending it to the ALU or any other part whichever is required. That is called instruction time. Execution time is the time where the ALU or the program takes to perform a particular action. That is execution time. And machine cycle, that is a combination of both instruction time and execution time. That is called machine cycle. Addition of both, combination of both. कितना टाइम लगा इंस्ट्रक्शन को रीड करके फेच करके सेंड करने में और एग्जीक्यूट होने में, दैट इज कॉल्ड अ कंप्लीट मशीन साइकिल. अंडरस्टैंड? यहां तक क्लियर है बेटा? एनी टिप, एनी पॉइंट और एनी डाउट टिल नाउ? यस अर्जु, सुदीक्षा, रेणुका, एनी डाउट बेटा? ओके
मैम, डेफिनेशंस विल कम और नॉट?
बिल्कुल आ सकती है बेटा, क्यों नहीं आ सकती. ठीक है, ओके. नेक्स्ट इज योर एडवांटेजेस और स्ट्रेंथ्स और कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर. हम बहुत सेकंड थर्ड क्लास से पढ़ते आ रहे हैं. व्हाट आर द वेरियस एडवांटेजेस और कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर? व्हाट आर द वेरियस स्ट्रेंथ्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर? यस आर्यन, व्हाट आर द वेरियस स्ट्रेंथ्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर? आर्यन, इफ यू आर प्रेजेंट इन क्लास, अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ एंड गिव आंसर. व्हाट आर द वेरियस strengths of computer? If you are not giving answer, that means you are not present in class. I will mark absent. I will mark absent.
Fast calculations.
रोज लग रही है. अगर आप लोग क्लास में आंसर नहीं कर रहे हो, you are not giving answer to my questions. ठीक है, मैं आपको particular नाम ले रही हूँ कि yes, you are supposed to give answer. But if you are not giving answer, that means you are not present in the class. You are just logged in and sleeping. ठीक है, तो if you are not giving answer, that means I will mark absent. I'm not giving marking you present. Okay.
Fast calculation,
that means your speed.
Accuracy.
Reliability. Storage. Okay. Can you explain me the reliability?
Ma'am, accuracy of the computer is always high. It can do work without tiring.
That is the reliability. That means there is no fatigue. It can do the work for many hours without any tiredness. Okay, that is your reliability. Second, we can rely on the answers, on the calculations, on the outputs of the computer because accuracy is very high. Okay, computer will always give the correct answer if our input is correct. अगर इनपुट में कोई प्रॉब्लम है या इंस्ट्रक्शन में कोई गलती है, देन योर आंसर कैन बी रॉन्ग. दैट मींस नॉट अकॉर्डिंग टू योर रिक्वायरमेंट. ठीक है, अदरवाइज आंसर इज करेक्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू द इनपुट. बट इफ यू थिंक कि नहीं, ये आंसर तो आना ही नहीं था, कुछ और आना था, दैट मींस देयर मे बी सम प्रॉब्लम इन द इंस्ट्रक्शन और देयर मे बी सम प्रॉब्लम इन द इनपुट डाटा. ओके, तो कंप्यूटर विल ऑलवेज गिव द करेक्ट आंसर. दैट इज योर एक्यूरेसी. स्पीड, इट विल परफॉर्म द एक्शंस और इट विल परफॉर्म द कैलकुलेशंस एट अ वेरी हाई स्पीड. हाई स्टोरेज, इट कैन स्टोर द डाटा, लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ स्टोर द डाटा. लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ डाटा कैन बी स्टोर्ड इन एनी काइंड ऑफ डिवाइसेज. देर आर मेनी डिवाइसेज अवेलेबल. आर्टिस्ट, वी आर हैविंग, ठीक है, वी आर हैविंग सो मेनी, नाउडेज वी आर हैविंग हार्ड डिस्क ऑफ मेनी साइजेस. ठीक है, अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ डाटा कैन बी स्टोर. यू कैन इमेजिन द अमाउंट ऑफ डाटा वी यूज इन अ वेरियस रिसर्च सेंटर्स और इन अ मेनली वेदर फोरकास्टिंग सेंटर्स और एनी साइंटिफिक रिसर्च सेंटर. दे आर हैविंग द डाटा फॉर मेनी मेनी ईयर्स एंड फॉर मेनी रिसर्चर्स. ऑल ऑफ देयर डाटा इज स्टोर्ड इन डाटा बेस. सो इट कुड बी अ मिलियन. कितने ज्यादा टीबीज का डाटा होगा, कितने ज्यादा आपके वो डाटा होगा कि दैट कैन बी स्टोर्ड एंड दैट कैन बी असेस्ड एज एंड व्हेन रिक्वायर्ड. सो दे आर हैविंग सम टाइम्स सम रिसर्च सेंटर्स और रिसर्च यूनिट्स आर हैविंग फुल लार्ज रूम इज देयर जस्ट हैविंग द वेरियस स्टोरेज डिवाइसेस विच आर लिंक टूगेदर. वन कंसोल इज देयर एंड ऑल द डाटा इज स्टोर्ड इन अ फुल रूम इज देयर टू स्टोर द डाटा ओनली. So that can be, computer can store a very large amount of data. It can process a very large amount of data at a very, very high speed. Okay, so that is a power, that is a strength of computer. Versatility. Versatility means? Yes?
It can do various tasks at one time.
Various types of tasks. It can do, perform or various types of actions. It is not compulsory कि ये सिर्फ calculation कर रहा है. It is showing us the videos. It is showing, it is a enable us to listen to the music. We can play games, we can do calculations, we can draw the things, we can make the new logos, we can type, we can draw anything, draw the various logos or icons or many paintings are there, 3D icons are there, 3D artwork is there. So many things are there which we can do on a computer. So high speed, high accuracy, reliable, versatility, and high storage capacity. So if there are so many advantages, so what are the disadvantages or weaknesses of a computer? If there are so many advantages, there are some weakness also, there are some disadvantages also. Yes, Raghav, what are the various disadvantages? Sudiksha, what are the various disadvantages? Sudiksha, give answer.
Zero IQ, lack of decision making power.
Okay, lack of decision making power, zero IQ, and?
No learning from past experiences.
No learning from past, that is no learning from past, that is your, no heuristics. Okay. Lack of decision-making power. What does that mean? What does that mean?
Like a computer cannot make any decision on its own. It will only depend on the data we provided.
Correct. It only depends on the instructions that we provide. It cannot take decision on its own or to check the data whether you are entering the correct data or not. Okay? It cannot take decision. Suppose one mistake is there, we made the correction. And in the future, again, same kind of mistake is there. It will not make the decision that yes, this is a mistake. So it is not learning from the past experiences. It is not. It is based only on the instructions given by the user, by the programmer, how they had programmed. It will work according to that program only. It will not take any decision on its own because zero IQ. It is not having any thinking capacity presently. But it is nowadays we all are listening about AI. What is AI?
Artificial intelligence.
That means scientists or researchers are providing these kind of things, these kind of powers to computer. They can be beneficial. They can be very disastrous also. So no heuristics. No heuristics means learning from past experiences or having some emotions. So these kind of things are not available with the computer. Zero IQ, lack of decision-making power, and no heuristics. Next is types of computer. What are the various...
Ma'am, disadvantages may improper use likh sakte hai, like cyber crime and hacking, something
uska usage ka disadvantage nahi dekh rahe hain. We are taking ki yes, itself jo machine hai, wo kahan lag kar rahi hai. जो कंप्यूटर मशीन है वो कहाँ लैग कर रही है वो तो यूजर पे डिपेंड करता है ना कि हाउ दे आर यूजिंग इट. ठीक है, दैट इज अ मैलिशियस जो है डिजायर्स ऑफ द यूजर हु आर यूजिंग इट इन अ बैड वे और यू आर हु आर यूजिंग इट इन अ रॉन्ग वे. ठीक है, तो वो मशीन का डिसएडवांटेज नहीं है, वो यूजर का सोच का डिसएडवांटेज है कि यस हाउ दे आर यूजिंग इट. ओके, सो वहां पे इसकी वीकनेस में इसके पॉइंट्स में नहीं लिखेंगे. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज यस
आई प्रॉब्लम जब कंप्यूटर ज्यादा देर से. मैम, हेल्थ इश्यूज से रिलेटेड लिख सकते हैं कि आईज पे स्ट्रेन पड़ता है एंड ऑल दैट.
दैट इज योर यूसेज, अब कम यूज करो. ठीक है,
ओके मैम, यस मैम.
दैट इज अगेन ऑन द यूजर कि हाउ द यूजर इज यूजिंग इट. वी आर राइटिंग द वीकनेस और डिसएडवांटेजेस ओनली फ्रॉम द मशीन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू कि मशीन में अगर ये एडवांटेजेस है कि स्पीड ज्यादा है, रिलायबिलिटी ज्यादा है, एक्यूरेसी ज्यादा है, तो मशीन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से कि मशीन में प्रॉब्लम क्या है, कंप्यूटर में प्रॉब्लम क्या है कि वो अपने आप नहीं सोच पा रहा है, वो जो भी काम कर रहा है यूजर के अकॉर्डिंगली कर रहा है. दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम विद द मशीन. ठीक है, only those kind of points will be written. Now types of computer, there are many categories on the based on which we can divide the various we can make the various categorization of computer based on the various things like purpose wise kya categorization hai, operation wise kya categorization hai, then digital computers ke aage further categorization hai. So there are many types of computers available. First is purpose-wise. Purpose-wise, we are having the category, two categories, special purpose computer and general purpose computer. Special purpose computers means the computers which are designed to perform only one type of task, only one type of purpose. They are solved, they are designed to solve only one purpose. Any example?
Ma'am, like ATM machine.
Bilkul correct. ATM machines. The first example jo humare mind mein aati hai, like ATM machines. They can work. They are computers, but they are designed only for one purpose, for withdrawing the money or for depositing the money sometimes also. So, similarly, ticket counters pe jo tickets ki jo machines lagi hai, they are designed only for booking the tickets. It could be in outside the cinema hall or it could be on a railway station. So they are designed only for a particular purpose, like in
a dishwashers and washing machine.
You can say, but they are embedded aa jayega kyunki usme hum log embed kar rahe hain. Haan, jana hai to special purpose hi hai. Theek hai? Okay, like in some big malls, kahi baar bade bahut sare bahut bade malls hain, wahan par they are having some consoles located at some places. Or on some floors, which can guide you to where you are and where the various floors are there. Yes, they can guide your path also. So they are designed only for that purpose. So general purpose computers, which are designed for the general public, general users, anybody can use it and for any purpose they can be used. They are called general purpose computers. Now, operation-wise, computers can be categorized as analog computer, digital computer, and hybrid computer. Analog computers means that work with continuous physical quantities like voltage, temperatures, or currents. So measuring those kind of things and calculating those kind of things, they are called analog computers. For example, anybody? They take the input in the form of amplifiers.
Thermometer,
your speedometers on your scooters or in your cars, speedometers. Okay, they are the analog computers which can measure the continuous physical quantities. Okay, it could be in voltage, it could be current, it could be speed, it could be temperature. Okay, so they are analog computers. Digital computers, the computers which work with discontinuous data converted into the binary form, that is zeros and ones. We all use laptop, use kar rahe, mobile, use kar rahe, tab, use kar rahe, desktop, use kar rahe. All these are the digital computers because they are storing the data in the form of zeros and ones. So, digital computers are much faster than the analog computers and are more accurate. Computers use for aapki jo BP machine, and that is also for analog computers. They are measuring the BP wagar. Computers are used for business and scientific applications. Are digital computers? They are comes in a variety of form. And based on their configuration, and is next is your hybrid computer. Hybrid computer, combination of both analog and digital computer. When we are combining the features of both, like ECG machine used in hospitals. So ECG machine is measuring your heart rate, okay? But displaying on a console and storing it, in digital form in your computers, and some features are combined, both of the features are combined, that becomes your hybrid computers. So many of the apparatus which we use in usually in hospitals, they are the examples of hybrid computers. Hybrid computers utilize the best qualities of both digital and analog computers. In these computers, some calculations take place in analog form and rest of them are placed in digital form. Hybrid computers are best used in hospitals to monitor the patient's vital signs, and they are also used for weather forecasting. Like, I think waves are measured, jo earthquake waves wagara measures hoti hai, they are using analog computer, but combining it with the digital computer. ठीक है, so weather forecasting के लिए हो गया, research purpose के लिए हो सकता है, hospitals में use हो सकता है, तो they are the combination of hybrid computers. Where we are combining the features of both analog and digital computers. Clear till now? Any doubt? Daljeet, Simran, Akhilesh, Anji beta, any doubt till now? Nitesh, Raghav? Okay. Okay. Next is types of digital computer. Digital computer, here we are reading because digital computers comes in a variety of forms. Variety of types are there of digital computers. So they can be categorized as embedded computers, microcomputers, mini computers, mainframe computers, and supercomputers. So we will discuss with them in one by one. Embedded computer, jaise abhi Dhiren ne shuru mein example di thi, washing machine. The washing machine is just doing the purpose or doing the work of washing the clothes, but a small chip is embedded in that washing machine so that it can control the washing of the clothes. Okay, how much time it should be given, how the water level should be measured, how much time should be given to the washing, how much timing should be given to the spinning, according to the weight of the clothes, according to the quantity of clothes. So all these things are measured with the help of small chip, which is embedded in washing machine, which is programmed to do the all these kind of tasks. Like microwaves. Microwaves are having many predefined purposes or predefined functions are already given there. For cake, for cookies, or for warming, or for defrosting. So many things are there. So we just have to press one button, it will work accordingly. It will set the timing accordingly. It will set the mode accordingly. Whether it is a micro mode or whether it is a grill mode. Okay, so that are set according to the predefined functions which are already programmed in the chip which is embedded in microwaves. So many things are there. Smartwatches are there. Chip is embedded. Okay, so where small chips are embedded, small programs are embedded in a device, that becomes your embedded computer. So these computers are in the form of tiny chips embedded within the circuitry of appliances such as televisions, LEDs, smart TVs, washing machines, wristwatches. These computers are typically pre-programmed for the specific task. Pehle se programmed hai, unko hum change nahi kar sakte. They will perform only in that particular way. Such as turning on to a particular television frequency or keeping the accurate time or so many things which, in which the embedded computers can be used. You can have so many examples. Okay, हाँ जी क्लियर है यहाँ तक बेटा. आई थिंक टाइम इज अप फॉर योर क्लास. वी विल डू नेक्स्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक्स, नेक्स्ट टाइप्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर इन द टुमारोज क्लास, एज वेल एज वी विल रिवाइज द टॉपिक दैट इज फॉर योर टेस्ट टुमारो. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू रिमेम्बर दैट टुमारो इज योर टेस्ट फॉर कैलसी पार्ट टू. ठीक है,
टेस्ट इज इन गूगल फॉर्म और रिटन?
फर्स्ट टेस्ट है, यस इट विल बी इन एमसीक्यू गूगल फॉर्म.
ओके मैम.
अगर एक ही है तो देन इट विल बी एट 4 o'clock. इन रेस्ट ऑफ क्लासेस वी आर हैविंग टू टेस्ट, दैट इज बाय द टाइम इज 5 o'clock फॉर रेस्ट ऑफ द क्लासेस. यस बेटा.
Ma'am, actually, I have tuitions at 5 p.m. So, can I give it later?
Better, your test will be at 4 o'clock.
Okay, ma'am, no problem.
Okay, 4 o'clock hoga. Okay, 4 o'clock. Kal ek hi test hai na, Hindi aur computer. Aur koi subject to nahi hai na, uske saath.
Ma'am, actually, I have not checked the
schedule. Nahi hai, beta, I am having the test schedule.
Ma'am.
You are not having any other test. Theek hai, aapka test 4 o'clock hi hai. ठीक है, 4 o'clock will be shared. Yes, बेटा.
मैम 4 o'clock से 15 minutes पहले हो सकता है?
नहीं, क्यों?